Sanket and I am from EMC2, and today we are going to discuss the topic that is electrostatics. So for example, we take a conductor that we name it as A and we place a positively charged body beside it. And we take another and name it as B, and again we place a positively charged body beside it. Now in the first case, the electrons present in the block will not accumulate here, but in the case B, the electrons which are present here will accumulate here on this side. So we observe that the positive and the negative charge attract. So this will become a conductor, and this one is the insulator. So we can define conductor as it allows the flow of electrons inside it, but insulators are those material which does not allow the flow of current through it. Now for example, we take a glass rod and a silk cloth and we rub it over. So the electrons will transfer from the glass rod to the silk cloth. So we take a glass rod and a silk cloth. So when we rub this, the electron present in this glass rod we transfer to this. So when we rub it, the electrons of glass rod will interconnect with the electrons of silk cloth and it will produce a charge. So by this we can define that charge is the electric property of the atomic particles. It is the electric property of the atomic particle of which the matter consists.
See the cancel matter.
So because we know that now we have studied that the electrons of glass rod will interconnect with the electrons of silk cloth. So when they interconnect, and after rubbing the glass rod, the charge is produced between the atoms. So we write here the atomic particles of which the matter consists of, because charge is produced between the atomic particles. Now the next topic is electrification. Electrification is the phenomenon by which an particle gets electrified. For example, we have just seen the example that is when we rub a glass rod over a silk cloth, the glass rod will get electrified. So we can write it is the holding of net charge. Now the third topic is frictional energy. So it is defined as friction due to electrification. So we have taken a glass rod and a silk cloth. So when we rub, the electron will get transferred from the glass rod to the silk cloth, and there is a charge produced, because when we rub, there a friction is produced by the friction, a charge is produced. Now we'll be studying the mass energy relation. So as we have seen that when we rub the glass rod over a silk cloth, the electron gets transferred from the glass rod to a silk cloth. So when they get transferred, the mass of silk cloth will be heavier than the mass of glass rod, because the silk cloth will gain an electron and the glass rod will lose an electron. So when an electron is lost, the charge becomes positive. So when a glass rod loses electron, so the charge for the glass rod will be charged as positive, and the silk cloth which gains electron will be charged as negative. Now if we increase, so when a charge is transferred from one body to another body, the mass also gets transferred from that body to another body along with the charge. So this was the mass energy relation.